continue to focus on upper body, but full body, and also the breath. And we both, Connie and I, have both been talking about the breath and how important it is to, especially right now, to keep those lungs healthy. And as we keep our body moving and keeping, you know, things going, it just, you know, naturally will keep those things healthy in our bodies. But we want to take time to actually breathe deeply, especially during the day when we're not breathing deeply and we're working and, you know, that sort of thing, we can forget. So we're going to make that part of our daily practice. All right. All right. So I'm going to go on back to my mat and we'll get started. All right. So just find that comfortable seat. So wherever that is for you today. And if you have a blanket, maybe prop your hips up on a blanket. Otherwise, just sitting down on your mat or the floor. And we'll just lightly rest the hands on the thighs, and you can bring the tops of the hands down if you feel like you need some grounding. We can flip the palms over to allow more energy into the body. All right, just decide what you need this morning. Close the eyes gently. And as you close the eyes, allow that to be a trigger to deepen the breath. All right, deep inhales through the nose. Exhale through the nose. Maybe you need to exhale through the mouth, that's fine too. But we are going to cultivate that deep breath, just elongating the inhales and exhales. Allow the spine to be nice and tall. Shoulders are relaxing down the back. Crown of the head reaches up toward the sky. Let the knees and the hips be soft and relaxed. And start to notice now the eyes. Notice the eye socket. Relax our eyes. If you've been staring at a computer screen or your phone, just allow those eyes to stop working for a minute. Maybe you notice whatever color is showing up for you behind the eyes, behind the eyelids. Relax the brow. And if you've been having trouble sleeping or staying asleep, this practice is so good for that. Any yoga practice will help you find that sleep, the deep, full breath, right? That breath helps us relax. Releasing the crown of the head, the scalp. Release the back of your head, the back of your neck. Another deep inhale through the nose together. Exhale through the nose. And as we're moving today, just start to notice the breath as it's moving in and out through the nostrils, right? Notice the temperature of the breath. Warm on the inhale, cool on the exhale. Maybe opposite for you. Cool on the inhale. Warm on the exhale. Just notice. Inhale, sweep the arms up over the head, bring the palms. palms together. Exhale, hands to the heart center. Inhale, sweeping up, turn the chin, look up toward the hand. Exhale, chin to the chest as you bring the hands to the heart. One more time, inhale, sweeping up, looking up. Exhale, chin comes down. Beautiful. Let's gently bring the hands back to the thighs and lift the chin. All right, you can switch the cross of your legs. You can straighten the legs. All right, whatever feels good. We're just going to do a little bit of neck and shoulders here as we're sitting. All right, so just gently roll the shoulders up toward the ears and down the back. We'll do that a few rounds, rolling the shoulders up and back, up and back. Continuing to breathe. And then the opposite direction. Forward. Good. And we'll pause here with the shoulders relaxed. Gently bring the right ear toward the right shoulder. Relax the shoulders away from your ears. A deep breath into the left side of your neck, so you might even feel this coming all the way down towards your left shoulder. Deep inhales and exhales. Notice the temperature of the breath. Beautiful. All right, let's take the right fingertips up to the side of the head. We'll gently apply just a tiny bit of pressure here. So you're really deepening that stretch along the left side. All right, keep breathing in and out through the nose. Beautiful. Now keep the head as it is, release the hand. We'll turn the chin to look over the right shoulder. Kind of maybe take your eyes and look back behind you, right? Kind of stretching those eye muscles. Good. On an exhale, gently bring the chin down across the chest. And as you do that, we'll take the left ear to left shoulder. Again, relax those shoulders away from your ears. Take a deep inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose. Continuing with your nice tall spine. And we'll take the left fingertips and gently place them on the head. Just a little bit of pressure here, right? Really getting into the right side of the neck now, maybe down toward the right shoulder. Breathe into it. Just gently turn the chin over the shoulder, the left shoulder. And then maybe look back behind you with the eyes. So we're stretching the eyes to the opposite side now. Good. Inhale. On your exhale, draw the chin down toward the chest. Bring the chin in toward the chest if it feels okay on your neck. This is too much on your neck. You can always just bring the head back up. Otherwise, have the chin into the chest, breathing again, opening the back of the neck. And for me this morning, I'm feeling it all the way down toward the side body, toward my lower back. So just notice where you're feeling this stretch. Chin to the chest, interlace the fingers, bring the hands behind your head, thumbs resting toward the base of the skull, and we'll gently pull up slightly with the thumbs, just a little bit, so we're stretching the back of the neck, keep the elbows open. Now on an inhale, we'll start to lift the chin, bring the head back towards your palms, and as you do that, we'll start to lift the head up, open the elbows wide, and gently press the head into the palm so it's kind of like a basket holding your head up, right? And then maybe you can go a little bit further, stretching through the thyroid gland, through the front of the neck. Getting into the lymph nodes, even down through the armpits. Good, inhale back to center. And on an exhale, we'll hinge over to the right. Left elbow comes up toward the ceiling. And maybe gently press the head back towards your hands one more time. Beautiful. Inhale, center. Exhale to the left. Good. Open the elbows wide. Maybe gently press the head toward the hands. So we're still kind of opening the neck, opening the shoulders, opening the chest. Inhale back to center. Release the arms, roll the shoulders, shake it out. Beautiful. All right. Let's go ahead and stretch those legs long down the mat. Good. Take a second here to sit up nice and tall, bringing the hands down beside your hips. Okay, finding our staff pose. Roll the shoulders down the back as you lift up through the crown of the head. Flex the feet. Start to engage the thighs. So as if you're going to draw the thighs back into the hip sockets. Okay? Roll the shoulders down the back. Breathing deep. Spread the toes wide. Inhale. On your exhale, curl the toes in. Hug them in toward the balls of the feet. Inhale. Spread the toes. Exhale. Curl. Inhale. Spread. Exhale, curl. Beautiful. And then we'll just spread those toes wide. Let's take a deep bend in the knees here. Even if you know you can come all the way down, we're going to ease into it. So bend those knees, flex the feet. Inhale, reach up. On your exhale, start to lead with the heart and fold toward the thighs. So the belly will rest down on the thighs. Immediately start to feel that back. Maybe it's opening. Rest the hands wherever they come down. Let the head release. Good, and deep breaths here. Beautiful. Now from here, inhale, lift up about halfway. You can keep the knees bent or start to straighten the legs down the mat a little bit more, taking the bend out of the knees, but of course if you need to bend the knees, definitely do that. Right, inhale, lift through the heart. On your exhale, walk the hands down. Inhale, we're going to lift up again just a little bit here, reach the heart forward. Exhale, come all the way down, release the head. Now you find what works best for you. All right, so listen to your body. If you need to bend those knees, bend them. If you need to come out of this, come out of it. Maybe you find a little bit of movement here, swaying a little bit from side to side, or you can stay still. But it might feel good, especially on the lower back. Inhale, start to roll yourself all the way back up. Roll the shoulders again down the back. Lift through the heart, finding that staff pose. Good. All right, let's bend the right knee. Bring it in. All right, and then we're going to take that right foot. You can either keep it to the inside of the leg or you can take it to the outside of the left leg. Okay, I'm going to do a little twist here. Sitting up tall with the spine. Bring the right hand behind the right hip and flex the left foot. Inhale, lift the heart. As you exhale, twist to look over the right shoulder, and then maybe that left arm can kind of wrap around the left or the right leg. And then just gently gazing back behind you. Nice tall spine lengthening. And just notice the back. Notice the twist here in the spine. See if you can deepen that breath. Now we'll gently come back around. Keep that leg over the opposite leg if you're doing that. And then we'll take the left hand to the outside of your left hip, right hand to the outside of your left hip, and just get a little counter twist in the spine. Good. And inhale back to center, extending the right leg down. All right, let's do the other side. Again, sitting up tall, bend the left knee. So again, you can keep the foot to the inside of the right leg or take it to the outside of the right leg. We're going to flex the right foot. Left hand behind your left hip. Inhale, elongate the spine. And exhale, twist to look over your left shoulder. Now you can take the right arm and kind of wrap it around the knee. And then look over, flex the right foot. Deep, full breath. Coming back to center, and we'll again take that counter twist. Sorry, we're going to take the hands to the outside of your right hip now, and just a little bit of a twist here. Good, and inhale back to center, extending the left leg down. All right, let's bend those knees, bring the feet down on the mat. We're actually going to find a little boat pose here. Now, for me, my tailbone is pretty bony, so I like to pad my tailbone with a blanket here. So we're going to start to lean back. Maybe the hands are on the hamstrings, maybe they're behind you, maybe they're not on your body. And then we'll just start to lean back, lift the hand, the feet up. Maybe the arms come out to the side, right? Maybe you keep those knees at a 90 degree, or maybe you straighten. Right? Flex the feet, keep lifting through the heart. Imagine there's a string pulling you up. Shake a little bit here. Maybe feel some heat building in the body. And exhale, lower the feet. Wrap those arms around your legs. Give yourself a nice hug here. Nice, all right. Let's release the arms and we'll come on over now to our hands and knees position. So if you need your blanket under your knees, grab your blanket or whatever you need, or you can fold your mat over to create a little pad if you need it, okay? Now we're going to bring the hands down, shoulders in line with the wrists, knees in line with the hips. Press down through the finger pads, lift the heart forward so we're really engaging through the upper body. If you feel like your elbows are locking out, bend the elbows slightly. Good, now we're going to do a few rounds of our cat-cow. Inhale, scooping through the heart, reach the heart forward. Exhale, round the spine, bring the chin to the chest. Inhale, scooping through the heart, reach it forward. And exhale, round. Let's do a few more of these on your own breath, slowing it down, slow, even breath. One more just like that. Inhale, coming forward. Exhaling to round. Beautiful. Let's pause on our tabletop. Good. Now inhale, take that right leg, extend it back and flex or press the ball of the foot down on the mat. So we're stretching through the right calf. Okay, gently pressing through the hands as you send that right heel back. Good. All right, now from here, we're going to come center again. Lift the right leg up, flex the foot, toes pointing down. All right, so we're going to do a little cat-cow with the right leg lifted. All right, inhale, scoop the heart, lift the heel a little bit. Exhale, as you round the spine, we're going to bring the knee toward the chin. Inhale, reach the right leg back, lift the heart. Exhale, round it in toward the center. Two more times, inhale, exhale. Inhale. And exhale. Hold here. Hold it in. And then we'll take that right foot. Step it between your hands. Right? Press down through the right foot. Right knee over the ankle. Inhale. Start to sweep those arms up over the head. Relax the shoulders down the back. Good. Spread the fingers wide. Lift the heart up. Do a little twist here. Take the left arm forward, right arm back. Maybe gazing toward the right thumb. Deep, full breaths here. Allow the heat to build in the body. Inhale, right arm comes back up, come back to center. Exhale, both hands around the right foot. Step the right knee back. Beautiful. All right, everything that we just did, we're gonna do that on the other side. So when you're ready, extend the left leg back, follow the foot down, stretch that left calf, right? Deep, even breaths here again. Back to center. Lift the left heel. Good. Flex that foot. All right, we're going to do that cat-cow here. Inhale, lift the heel, lift the heart. Exhale, round the spine. Bring the chin toward the chest. Inhale, reach it forward. And exhale, round. Good. Two more. Last one, inhale, extend, and exhale, curl. Beautiful, hold it here, hug it in, and then step the left foot between your hands, all right? Bring the left knee over the ankle. Inhale, sweep up into that low lunge here, reach up, relax the shoulders. Good, deep, even breath. I'll take that right arm, reach it forward. Take the left arm, reach it back. Finding that nice twist here. Maybe looking toward the left fingertips. Inhale, reach both arms up. Exhale, bring the hands down around your left foot. We're gonna step the left knee back. Place the hands down on the mat again. Now walk the arms forward. So you have some length here in the arms. Shoulders kind of at an angle toward the wrist. So we're taking that crease out of the wrist joint. Press through the finger pads. Press through the balls of the feet. Gently take the hips toward the heels slightly. Right? Feel that nice stretch through the upper body. Pause and breathe. Press through the balls of the feet. Now we're going to hover those knees off of the mat just a couple of inches, all right? Feel what that feels like in your body. Maybe you're shaking. Building strength, building heat, right? Press through the feet. Inhale, send the hips up. Release the head down toward the mat. If your elbows are locking out, bend the elbows a little bit. Bend one knee at a time. Stretch through those legs. Maybe the hips sway a little bit as you're moving. Keep breathing deep. Good. Pausing in our downward dog, release the head. Maybe shaking the head, yes and no. Good. On your next inhale, looking forward. Exhale, as we walk up, we're going to cross our feet, one in front of the other, as you walk up toward the top of your mat. And once you get there, bring the hands around the feet, let the head come down. Maybe you bend the knees enough to where your belly's resting on your thighs, like we did earlier. And just shaking the head again, yes and no, or making little circles with the head. Maybe you flip the palms over, relax the elbows. The back of the hands come down on the mat. to roll slowly up through the spine. Just real slow here, like you're moving through mud. All right, roll the shoulders down the back as you come up. Inhale, reach the arms up over the head. Exhale, hands to heart center. Good. If you have a blanket or something on your mat, you might want to scoot it off to the side. All right, now we'll come to mountain pose here. You can either have the hands by your sides or you can bring the palms in front of the heart. Whatever feels best for you. Close your eyes, spread the toes wide. All right, root down through all four corners of the feet. Take a deep breath in through the nose and sigh it out. Relax those shoulders. Again, inhale through the nose. Sigh it out. Good. Now inhale and exhale through the nose again. Regulating the body. Now, as if you're going to pull the mat apart with your feet, engage the inner and outer thighs. Gently draw the navel toward the spine. Engaging the core. Finding that foundation through the feet. Recall your intention. Maybe your intention changed. Maybe the color behind the eyelids have changed. Walk up toward the top of your mat now. Again, we're going to root down through those feet. Inhale, sweep the arms over the head. Exhale, bend the knees and fold forward. Inhale, hands to the shins, halfway lift. Exhale, bend the knees, fold. Plant the hand. We'll step back into our plank pose. All right, root down through the finger pads. Press the mat away from you. And we're going to shift forward and back here. Just shifting forward and back. If this bothers your wrist, you can do this down on your elbows. You can do it with your fist down on the mat. That might be a little better. All right, so just notice what you need. And we'll pause here in our plank. Shift slightly forward. Hug your elbows towards your ribs as you bend the elbows. Come all the way down. Roll the shoulders down your back. Press through the tops of your feet. Inhale, lift into your baby cobra, reach through the heart, so really send that heart forward. On your next exhale, lower. Good. Tuck your toes. Inhale, plank. Pause and plank, strengthen the body. And exhale, just coming right into our downward dog. Release the head down toward the mat. Now this next little flow, you can definitely do it on your knees if it feels like you're running out of steam or need a little break, right? So what we're gonna do, we're gonna try not to move the arms or the feet. We're gonna inhale, scoop the back up toward the ceiling like cat, and then come forward into plank. Inhale, reach the heart forward a little bit. Exhale, round the spine, come back into downward dog. Try not to scoop the hands or the feet. Inhale, round the spine, come forward, plank. Good. Shift the heart forward just a little bit, and exhale, downward dog. Do that one more time, rounding through the spine to come forward to plank. As you come forward, lift through the heart, and then exhale, downward dog. Nice. All right, from here, inhale, right leg comes up. Exhale, bend the knee, shift forward, hover the knee over the mat. And then we'll place the foot up between the hands, however you want to get there. Take the right knee over the ankle. And then we'll take that left foot, bring it parallel with the back edge of your mat. Draw the right hip back so it's kind of pointing back toward the back of your mat. Press through the feet and we'll sweep up into warrior two. Relax the shoulders. Let's flip the palms over. Good. Now, from here, we're going to take our hands, interlace the hands behind the back, right? Press through the right foot as you're bending the knee. And just draw the knuckles down so they're kind of coming toward your left heel. Lift the heart, lift the chin a little bit. Make this a little bit of a heart opener or back bend. Stay in warrior two, release the arms. Just gonna roll the shoulders. Nice, and then we'll open the arms back out, bend the elbows, gazing over the right fingers. Feel the heat in that right thigh. Exhale, bring the arms around the front foot. Come to the ball of your back foot. Bring the palms down gently. Step the right foot back, plank. Now again, you can always step back into knees down, okay? So listen to your body. Now we're gonna inhale, shift slightly forward like we did earlier. Exhale, just come right up into our downward dog. Release the head. Other side, inhale, left leg comes up. When you're ready, exhaling, shifting forward, hover that knee, hug it in, and then step the foot forward. All right, left knee over ankle. Right foot comes down so it's parallel. So press through both feet equally. Inhale, sweep into that warrior two. Keep the left knee bent. Reach the arms out. Again, let's flip those palms over. Bend the left knee. Gaze over the left fingers. Now engage your inner thighs. Imagine you're going to draw your mat toward each other. Or toward your feet toward each other on your mat, so you're engaging those inner thighs. Good. Keep bending through the left knee. Now this time again, we're going to interlace the fingers, or if you want to grab opposite elbows, you could do that too. Right, so just whatever you want to try. Draw the knuckles if you're interlacing the fingers. Draw them down towards your right heel and lift the heart. Deep breaths, engage those thighs. Maybe close your eyes. Notice how the breath is serving you in this pose. Beautiful. Release the hands. Inhale, reaching back out into warrior two. Bend the elbows. Maybe roll the shoulders a little bit. And then we'll bring the hands around the left foot. Come to the ball of the back foot. And we'll just step the back foot forward. Inhale, halfway, reach through the spine. Bend the knees, exhale, fold. Let's separate our feet about as wide as the mat or a little bit wider than your hips. All right, let yourself fold down here. So maybe you're grabbing opposite elbows, just hanging down. Maybe you're swaying a little bit. Maybe the hands are on the mat, just kind of going back and forth, swaying from side to side. Release the head. Find a little bit of organic movement here. Let's pause here if you're moving and just relax the head down. Now press through the feet. Inhale, we'll slowly start to roll back up. As you come up, release the shoulders. Good. All right, let's keep the feet wide. I'm going to open them just a little bit wider. Not as far as you can go. Just a little bit wider than we were. Okay, turn the toes out toward the corners of the mat. I'm going to work a little bit more on hips and shoulders. So bend the knees, coming down into our little goddess squat here. Right, root down through the feet. Keep lifting up through the lower body, right? Through the pubic bone. Lift up through the heart. Bring the hands in front of the heart. Relax the shoulders. Good. Take a breath. Engage those inner thighs. As if you're going to draw your heels toward each other, right? Engage. Good. Hands to the thighs. Press through the feet. Inhale. We're going to come all the way up. Reach up. Exhale, hands to heart center, bend the knees into goddess squat. Inhale, sweep up. Exhale, bend. One more. Inhale, sweeping up. You got this. Exhale, bend and pause. Good. Hands come to the tops of your thighs. Inhale, and on your exhale, drop the right shoulder down as you look over the left shoulder. Inhale, center. Exhale, left shoulder down as you look over the right. Let's do one more on each side. Inhale, exhale, right. Inhale, center. Exhale, left. Beautiful. Inhale, center. Press through the feet. Inhale, straighten those legs. Reach the arms out, star pose. Open the arms wide. Draw the thumbs back. Lift the chin. Maybe you're feeling a little bit more energy coming into the body. That prana, that life force, flowing in and out of us with the breath. Inhale, reaching up, and exhale, just bring the hands down to the waist, and we'll step or hop your feet back together. Awesome. Let's find a little mountain pose. Roll the shoulders down the back. Bring the arms down by the sides, palms facing forward. Maybe the chin comes up slightly. All right, root down through the feet, engage the inner and outer thighs. Try not to grip down with the toes. Toes are light. And just start to come back to that deep, even breath. Noticing heart rate. Maybe recall your intention. And maybe let this be your mantra. Inhaling peace, exhaling love, again inhaling peace, exhaling love. You can stick with that or you can't, you don't have to. If it feels good, keep breathing in and out, peace and love. Those arms over the head. Bend the knees. Exhale, just kind of bend those knees to come down to seated. Right. When you come down, go ahead and extend those legs along the mat. Flexing the feet here, kind of like we did earlier with our staff pose. And then, but this time we're going to relax the legs. Right? We're not engaging, we're just relaxing. Relax the shoulders, gently pressing the hands down on the mat. Do one last boat pose before we come all the way down, just to keep that core nice and strong, right? You can have a padding or not. We'll keep, bring the feet down on the mat, hands behind the hamstrings. Lift the feet, and then maybe keeping that heart lifted up will help you engage through the legs more. Right, reach the arms, maybe the legs straighten. Maybe this one feels different than it did earlier. You can come all the way down to your back right now, or you can bend the knees and then scoot yourself all the way down. Reach the arms over the head, stretch through the feet, really stretch through the core, stretch through the entire body in this nice morning stretch. Maybe exhale through the mouth. Good. Release the body down. Open the feet a little bit wider than your hips. Let the feet kind of fall out to the corners of your mat. Bring the arms down by your sides. Let the palms face up toward the sky. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Hold that inhale in. And exhale, sigh it out. Let your body be super heavy here. Close the eyes gently again and relax those eyes. Relax the eye socket. Coming back to your natural breath. Allow the shoulders to melt down toward the mat. You to stay here in the shavasana. I'm going to sit up so you can hear me a little bit better. And just relaxing the crown of the head here. Relaxing the scalp. Allow the back of your neck to be heavy, moving down toward floor. Relaxing the cheeks and the jaw. Relaxing the collarbone, the shoulders. Let the spine be grounded, rooted down. Let the chest be open and soft. Upper arms, forearms, and wrists are heavy. Relaxing the palms and the fingers. Let the solar plexus release. Let all of the inner organs release. Soft and relaxed. Allow the lower back just to gently melt down toward the floor. Release the hips and the glutes. Allow your pelvic bone to be soft. Relaxing inner thighs, hamstrings, upper thighs, knees. Allow the shins and calves to be soft and relaxed. Relaxing ankles, tops of the feet, soles of the feet, and toes. Spirit is grounded deep in the earth. I am calm, strong, centered, and peaceful. I am able to let go of fear and trust that I am eternally safe. I am worthy of all things beautiful. Deepen your breath. Maybe wiggling fingers and toes. Maybe turn the corners of the mouth up, smiling. When you're ready, bending one knee in at a time toward the belly. Taking taking your time to roll over to your side. Gently, slowly making your way back up to that seated position, whatever feels best in your body. Relax those shoulders. Bring the palms together in front of the heart. Let's take a deep breath together. Inhale through the nose. And exhale, sighing it out. And just release the head down toward the heart, thanking yourself for coming to your mat today. And thank you so much for allowing me to guide you. Namaste.